What Should I Do Wednesday. I hope you guys are having a fantastic, wonderful middle of your week. I know I am. Even though I'm exhausted, I did not sleep very well last night, but I can tell you right now that nothing is going to kill my buzz. Like, I am so, so happy today because after last night when I went to my job interview, I am happy to announce that I got the job that I went to the interview for. And it has made me so excited. I was wanting this job really bad. I knew that I would love it. I knew that I would do well in it. And I really, really wanted it. And when you really, really want something and you get it, it's like you just want to freaking run a marathon. I want to like shout from the rooftops. I am so excited. I have bugged everybody I know. I have texted, messaged, tweeted, freaking called. I am just like ridiculous. I feel like a kid in a candy store. I feel like I'm 16 and got my first car. Like, it's ridiculous. I am over the moon. I don't think I've been this happy. Like, look at the smile on my face. Like, I can't get the smile off my face. I've been bounding around all day. Like, I'm super, super excited. And the outpouring of like love and support I've gotten from my friends and my family has been wonderful and amazing. And it's made it even more better. Like, when I have such an awesome little group of friends that like get so excited for me, and that even like just feeds my high and I get even more excited. So I'm so excited. I'm over the moon. I cannot wait. I start Monday and it's such a relief and it's such a weight lifted off of me, because I didn't know how easy it was going to be. I mean, sometimes you can find a job in 2 weeks, sometimes it takes 6 months. Like, it just depends on what you're looking for and what you're available to do and what you're ready to do. And this just happened to come into my life and fall into my lap, and it was just meant to be. It was fate. Like, I'm so excited. I'm gonna love the people I work with. We're all just a really small little group of girls that love what we do and love to make people feel good about themselves and love to have a good time. So I get to go to work and be myself, which I love. Like, I don't have to be all stuffy and weird and whatever. I can be Jazzy. I can be Rachel. I can just be myself. And I absolutely love that. I was in the store last night and after my interview, kind of talking to everybody and introducing myself to everybody that was there. And the music was playing on the speakers and I'm just kind of bopping around. And they're like, we love that. We love that you can dance and not even care. Like, I'm going to be the girl. They're going to walk into the store and I'm going to be like, fixing stuff on the rack or, folding stuff. And I'm going to be bopping along to the music and just making people feel amazing. I want people to walk in to my store and every day's party. Like, that's how it's going to be. It's going to be a blast. I want you to come in knowing you're going to have a great time while you're in here, because I'm going to make it that way. Like, it's going to be amazing. And I cannot wait. I'm so excited. Monday cannot get here fast enough. My car is fixed. Thank God she is back. Like, Stella got her groove back. She is faster than she was. She sounds better. Oh, she's so much happier. Like, it's almost like the car is even smiling. Like, it's just great. My world right now is, I have a great group of friends. I'm happy. I have a job that I'm gonna love. My car was not like dead. I'm just over the moon. Now, with all that being said, I want to reiterate really quick before I get started with the actual video that even though I'm working full-time now and I'm going to be doing this job and it may get busy and crazy over the holidays as, Labor Day is approaching and Christmas and Black Friday and Thanksgiving, whatever, I'm still doing my videos. Whether they are done on a Saturday night in my pajamas or they are done super early in the morning before I even go to work, I will get them done. Somehow, some way, I am not going to like lapse on my duties with the page, because you guys were first. You guys are my family and my friends, and I love and care about all of you. And I know you enjoy my videos as much as I enjoy giving them to you. So don't fret. They will still be posted. They may be posted late, they may be posted early, but by God, they will be here hell or high water. K. But we are not here to watch me flop and flip around because I'm so excited about my job, or to hear about my new video schedule. We are here for What Should I Do Wednesday, which is where I answer all of your general paranormal related questions that you guys asked me all up on the Facebook page. Now, I did get one question on the page, which I am going to answer, and then I'm going into a rant. Okay, so I'm just warning you now. It's Mini Rant Wednesday. Paranormal related, but Mini Rant Wednesday. But first, I will answer the question that I was asked on the page, which is from Tiffany Riley, and she wanted to know, she has a friend who has a spirit in her home, a spirit husband in her home, as well as several other spirits, and it's starting to affect her mood, and she's really concerned for her friend, and her friend won't do anything about it because she doesn't want the husband to leave. And she's basically asking me, what do I do? Help! Sadly enough, you can't do anything. I mean, what you're doing what you can do. You're encouraging her to get help. You're encouraging her to cleanse her home. She's afraid of losing the spirit that's good, even though there may be something very bad there or very negative kind of affecting her mood and affecting her daily life. And so, unfortunately, you kind of are between a rock and a hard place, and you're just going to have to really stand back and continue to encourage her to, you know, cleanse her home, get rid of it, let go of it, because if something negative is there and it's really affecting her, it sounds to me like she's going into oppression, which is not good. That is the first stage of possession, and that is bad, bad, bad. Like, that can be bad for her, bad for anybody else involved, and just express that to her. Don't be negative about it, but just be a concerned friend about it and be like, look, you know, we love you, we care about you, we don't want to see you go through this, and we understand your apprehension and your reservation about cleansing your home, but something's got to give. You've got to do something because you're not yourself. And I think it's going to have to be something where she just realizes it within herself. Maybe there's going to be a pivotal moment or an event that's going to take place that is really going to wake her up and kind of snap her out of it. And she's going to be like, oh God, maybe, you know, I don't need to be doing this. And then again, it may not happen. And unfortunately, you kind of just got to let that play out. You can't, unfortunately, let that affect, you know, you can't let that, what do I want to say, like, you can't let it play out, but you can't necessarily push the issue either. You've really got to just kind of stay back and do what you can from a distance, and maybe even distance yourself. Maybe if she loses everything that she treasures, her friendships, her family, that'll wake her up a little bit, because hopefully her family and her friends that are here are going to be far more important than whatever she's dealing with at home in the spirit world. So continue to be a support to her. Continue to encourage her to cleanse her home and to rid herself of everything in the house, good, bad, and ugly, because the good may be good, but the bad and the ugly can get really bad and ugly really fast. And I know the last thing you want to do, because you care about her, is to see something really bad happen to her. And if she's going into oppression, it could get really, really, really ugly. So my best advice is just continue to be the support. Continue to encourage her to cleanse her home and rid herself of everything going on. And then, you know, and then just stand back and wait, because unfortunately there's not much else you can do. As I center myself. So I had a whole list of questions. I was going to go all techie and get all technical and electronic based. And then I went out of my house and got coffee and was doing stuff on the page on my phone. And a curious party at Starbucks, seeing the word Ghost Adventures, asked me about the show. You know, it happens. I told him, yeah, I'm a huge fan. I help admin a page on Facebook that's for all things Ghost Adventures and paranormal related. We got to talking about the page, and he's like, you know, I don't get it. I don't get this paranormal fad. And I thought, oh, hell, here we go. And I said, oh, really? And I'm always one for debate. If you know me at all in any capacity, I don't have a filter. You piss me off, you know it. And I'm all about a good debate. So I thought, oh, hell, here we go. I was like, oh, really? And he's like, yeah. He's like, you know, I don't necessarily not believe in the paranormal, but I think that people get too wrapped up in it. I think it just becomes all-consuming. And I was like, oh, how so? You know, I'm just pressuring it on. You know, I'm poking the sleeping bear. And he's like, well, for example. And I'm like, oh, me. Okay, he knows me all of a sudden. Hell no. I was like, hold my earrings, because here we go. Hold my weave. I'm done. I can't deal with this right now. Mind you, it's early, and I have had one cup of coffee. So he really picked a wrong time to poke the sleeping bear. He's like, you admin a page, right? I was like, yeah, I have, you know, there's six other people who do it with me. But yes, I'm one of seven who admin this page. And he's like, and there's a lot of people who are on it. I was like, yeah, we have almost 6,000 members. And he's like, and all of you are into the same stuff. I'm like, yeah, keep going. What are you talking about here? And he proceeds to tell me that we are basically living in an altered reality. See the smile on my face? We know how well this went down. I was like, oh, really? He's like, yeah, I think you all are crazy. Okay? How so? Because we're fans of a TV show? Or because we believe in the paranormal? He's like, yeah, you little Ghostbusters was what he called us, which I thought was kind of cute. Live in an altered reality where you think that if you take a piece of equipment into a haunted location, then we get all this massive, amazing evidence. He's like, that's all staged. He's like, all of that's scripted. He just went on and on and on about how the show was scripted and how the equipment they use is rigged to make you look and see all this stuff. And I said, so for the people who've experienced it, they're crazy. And he's like, yeah, pretty much. And I just went off. I was like, look, you don't know me. You came up to me because you were snooping on my cell phone, looking over my shoulder at what I was doing. I was like, you have no right to judge me or what I do in my spare time, because you don't even know my first name. And he just looks at me. I think he thought I was this meek, because he was kind of a bigger guy. And I think he thought I was this meek little girl who was going to let him, you know, I was going to either walk away or I was going to lay down and listen to whatever he had to say. Oh, hell no. He picked the wrong girl to mess with on the wrong morning, because I was tired. And so I looked at him and I said, you have no right to judge me or my friends or my family on what we do in our spare time, because you don't know me. He's like, look, little girl. I'm like, excuse me? Look, little girl. I was like, I'm a grown ass woman. I was like, what I believe in and what I watch on TV is my damn business. Okay? Okay. And I was like, and second of all, that equipment that they rig, you can't rig that stuff. You can't make the stuff up. The stuff that I've experienced, the stuff that my friends have experienced, the stuff that I've seen on the show that is not scripted, by the way. Okay, thanks. Bye. You can't make up. It happens. It's something that you've experienced. I've heard live EVPs. I've heard it with my own ears. I was like, and until you have heard it or heard otherwise, you can keep your opinions to your damn self, because I'm not going to listen to it. I was like, this is ridiculous. So I stood in a public place ranting my ass off about the importance of equipment in the paranormal world, which I'm going to give my opinion on right now. To me, digital recorders, the Ovilus, the SB7 and SB11 Spirit Box, the SLS Kinect Cam, infrared still cameras, standard video cameras, the new Pilfer device, all of these pieces of equipment have allowed the paranormal world to take steps in being closer to proving that the paranormal is a science, that there is science, there's a science to it. I know in my heart of hearts that there will never be a day where we can perform a paranormal experiment in a lab. You can't, because the paranormal is unexpected. It doesn't work on a schedule. that's the beauty of it. It's a beautiful chaos that isn't always explainable. And that's the amazing part about it. When you can live your life saying that you've experienced the unexplainable firsthand, you felt the energy, you've experienced the emotion, and you've done so with a goddamn digital camera and a digital recorder and a little spirit box of radio frequency, and you've made that contact and you've experienced that, it's one of the most amazing things that you can ever experience in your lifetime. And I haven't had the experiences. I've had paranormal experiences. I've had plenty of them. I've heard EVPs, and I've experienced, you know, seeing orbs and apparitions, you know, through photos and things like that. I've seen things move. I've felt presences in my house. Like, there's no doubt in my mind that it does not exist. But for someone to come up to me who doesn't know me and just spew, I don't stand for that. Like, it drives me nuts. Like, I cannot stand it. You know, when people in the paranormal world, they experience it all the time. Everybody's a skeptic. Everybody's a critic. And that's fine. You are entitled to be a skeptic. You are entitled to have your own opinion. I cannot tell you no, and I cannot knock you for that. By all means, please have your own opinion. But have some evidence to back it up. You need, if you're going to have an opinion, you need to have some foundation to back it up. I mean, I could go on all day about how my conversation with this guy went. He walked away with his mouth shut. I can promise you that. Because I had evidence to back it up. I had a foundation to stand on where he did not. He just wanted to rant and get something started. He wanted to be an asshole. Pretty much. Sorry. That was the truth. He thought he seen this meek little girl who didn't know anything about anything and left with his mouth hanging open. I asked him questions he could not answer. I asked him things that he thought he knew stuff about and he didn't know a damn thing about it. And here I am talking about the SLS Kinect Cam and how Kinect technology from the Xbox can map a spirit and you can see it on a camera that you can't see with your own eyes, or how you can hear something on a digital recorder that you couldn't hear with your own ears, or how you can hear something with your own ears when it's strong enough, and how an EMF pump emits electromagnetic field to create an environment for a spirit to allow itself to manifest. And it just amazes me at the stupidity of people who think they know what they're talking about and have zero idea. It's just, it's so important for the paranormal world to stand their ground. And that's why it is so important. Because haters gonna hate. And today was not how I wanted to do my video. This was not what I wanted to talk about. But I couldn't let it go. And I knew that it was so important for me to just stand up for all 6,000 of us. I just could not stand there and let this guy spew crap he didn't know anything about. It was ridiculous. So, in closing, equipment used during a paranormal investigation is extremely important. It allows us to turn skeptics into believers. It allows us to gather information that we didn't know. It allows us to make contact with the spirit world. It allows us to help spirits move on. It allows us to grow in our own spiritual journey. It allows us, for those of us with gifts, to grow in our own journey as an empath, a medium, a psychic, any of the above, a sensitive, all of the above. You gain so much from putting yourself in that world and putting yourself out there and opening yourself up to that environment. And I will be damned if anybody is going to tell me anything different. Huh. But that is all I have for What Should I Do Wednesday. I will be back on Friday for GA Flashback Friday, where I will be recapping one of our past episodes of Ghost Adventures. Until then, stay happy, stay healthy, stand up for the paranormal world, and have a great rest of your week. I will see you Friday. Much love and happiness. Bye, guys.